everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be doing the weekly pick a card. This is for the 23rd to the 1st of March, which is great. That means we're going into March soon, which is really, really good. So let's get started with this reading then, and let's see what's going on for you in the week. So we have group number one, group number two, and group number three, and let's get started. So starting off with group number one. Hello, group number one. Let's get started with your reading. Let's see what's going on for you for this week. We're going to pull some cards, and I also have some tarot as well that I'm going to pull a little bit later. So we have a fiery climax approaches, full moon in Aries, which is lovely. I feel like I put this card too close to the candle. Okay, I'm going to move it away. There we go. I don't want a fire hazard. We then have the unfinished symphony. And then we also have time for a nap. That is so lovely. Let me bring this camera back as well. Okay, so we also have from the astrology deck, we have Taurus, which is lovely. Taurus, the bombshell. Beautiful. Okay, so just by looking at this, this is kind of the overall general view of your week. So when I see this, you guys really have something that is, this is like lots of mixed messages. So for a lot of you, this is going to resonate with some of you, maybe not. So just bear with me. So for some of you guys, I feel like there is something that you need to keep going and you need to keep carrying on with. And with the fact that it says unfinished symphony, it's giving me the vibes that you still need to carry on with something and you just got to relax into it and just keep going. But what I'm also feeling is if you guys feel like you are kind of ready for like a change, I do feel like there's a fiery climax approaching in terms of what you've been working on and what you've been waiting for. Possibly it's been really slow, possibly it's been taking its sweet ass time. I do feel like for you guys, there's going to be a really big change in terms of like a fiery climax that you've been waiting for. You could be meeting an Aries or a Taurus as well this week. But this full moon in Aries is really giving me the vibe that you guys are really kind of bringing up a lot of fiery energy. And foxes, this little fox guy here, really reminds me of that energy of, yeah, that really like fiery energy, very sly, kind of, you want to go forward, but it's just not the right time yet. I feel like for you guys, this is going to take a little bit longer than what you expected. And I feel like it's not going to take too much longer. It's almost going to be like an unexpected meeting. I'm hearing an unexpected meeting with something or an unexpected something or other coming around. You have thought, you thought like, wow, maybe I need to keep going with this, or maybe like I still need to like work on myself. But then actually something else comes in and it actually brings up this new change, you know. So maybe you think, actually, for some of you it could take a little bit longer, but for others of you, if you feel like something is coming, then it's definitely coming this week. Thank you to the lovely girl who bought this for me on my Amazon wish list. Honestly, it's amazing. You guys buy me card decks, absolutely love it. The link is down below if you guys want to purchase anything for me from my wish list. This is really gorgeous. It feels like you guys have got complete control this week, and Taurus is very grounded, so I do feel like you guys are really kind of going forth. And the fact we've got like the ram and then we've got the bull, very, very strong headed energy. In terms of work, you guys are going to be really, really good, so you guys are going to be totally fine. So let's have a look and see what's happening for Monday. Okay, is this just for Monday? Okay, I want two cards for Monday. So we've got the World and the Nine of Swords, Tuesday, the Tower. This makes so much sense. Okay, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, beautiful, and Sunday. Okay, not so beautiful, but we can have a look, see what this sort of energy is. And underneath, we've got the Knight of Pentacles, definitely an earth sign around you, or you're really working on your business, you're really doing well with your business, and things like that. Okay, so let's have a look and see what's going on. So on Monday, we've got the World and the Nine of Swords. This is basically, as it shows there, it's basically like an ending and a new start. So something that you've basically been waiting for. I do feel like these three cards are basically all in one. So this could be Monday or Tuesday that you start something new. Or you think, actually, I'm ready to let go and I'm ready to move forward onto something I really enjoy. For a lot of you, it can be ending an old relationship, ending work life, an old job. Sorry guys, it's late. It's always late when I film these. I need to start doing them earlier. but yeah, I do feel like it's going to be great. On Wednesday, there's a nice new offer coming in of love. I definitely feel like could be somebody like a soulmate, it could be a past life person, somebody you knew in a past life. It could also be somebody you used to know. Somebody that I used to know. Somebody. Yeah, it could be a Taurus as well. Could even be a water sign also here. We've got Taurus, Aries and the water sign. Yeah, definitely got some earth energy here. But yeah, it could be someone you're meeting and it starts off a new cycle and it's really, really good. I feel like this could also be, yeah, like a definitely a love offer for you guys who are single. Could also be just a new friend. I feel like for those of you who are in a relationship, it's going to be something that just really suits you, whatever that means to you. Maybe like a new hobby or just an end to an old job, start to a new one, or just something you really enjoy. You're going to treat yourself to it, I feel. But it feels like childhood energy. So it's going to be something you possibly wanted to do when you were a child and then you start it up. The Three of Swords at the end of the week, possibly you're just feeling a little bit of loss from whatever you kind of left behind. But I feel like that's only just because you need to get used to this new energy coming in. The new energy is absolutely beautiful. I feel like on Saturday you're going to be absolutely loving life. Yeah, I really, really love that. I'm getting a weird word and I'm just going to tell you guys because I'm honest in my readings. I'm getting the word rimming. Okay, so I don't know what that means. I'm not going to go too into it. But there's something that is kind of around the edge, like around the corner. Like you're basically... You know when they have those those charity things where they have like a bowl in like a restaurant or like in a shopping centre and you put the coin in and it goes all the way around and it drops down in the bottom? It's like that. You're kind of starting on the rim and you're kind of going all the way around and you're slowly getting to the point and then boom, drop to the bottom and boom, you've got your success. You know, it's almost like you're starting that momentum. You know, I really hope this is making sense. I feel like this is very metaphorical, this reading, but I love it. So yeah, absolutely beautiful, guys. Don't worry about the past. It's not important. Maybe somebody comes out that could have caused you a little heartbreak, but you're just going to dismiss them. You're going to be like, yeah, whatever. Don't really care. I'm going to have a look into this Three of Swords a little bit more and see what else. What's this Three of Swords about? Beautiful. Yeah, exactly. Literally what I said. I love it when it matches up. Literally just because you're mourning something that you used to have. Maybe an old job. Thinking, was it the right decision? Yes. Fuck yes. It definitely was the right decision. And you're moving on, girl. Girl or guy, you are moving on. Go for it, guys. So thank you so much for watching. If you'd like a private reading, all my information is down below. I love you guys and I'll speak to you very soon. Namaste. Bye. Hello, group number two. Let's get started with your reading. Let's see what's happening for you this week. We have, it's time to take action. That is absolutely amazing because the first group had also had an Aries card, which was, excuse me, let me have a look. A Fiery Climax Approaches. That's literally what group one had. That's amazing. So much Aries energy. We then have, ooh, Milk and Honey. Beautiful. I've never used this card deck before, so I'm really, really excited. Someone from my Amazon wish list bought it for me, and I'm absolutely amazed. And they also bought one of my crystal necklaces as well, so I'm really, really excited. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, then I will be releasing them very soon. I'm trying to look up for a website as well to make one as well. But anyway, moving on. We're gonna talk about that at some point, but not yet. Now is not the time. So we have It's Time to Take Action, Milk and Honey, and Treasure Island. Beautiful. Oh my God. You guys know how much I love this card. This is one of my favorite cards. Okay, I need to calm down. I need to freaking calm down. Right, you guys have definitely got something really good and you're really going forward into something you really enjoy. This feels like you're bathing in like milk and honey. You're bathing in absolute happiness. And there's something you're going to unlock. Something is going to really come forward. And it could be a water sign, but it could be like a message of love, I feel like. Yeah, it feels like it. Someone is coming towards you, I'm hearing. Someone is coming towards you. Something is coming towards you. I feel like it's to do with career, but it can also be to do with love as well. 51 and 9, so 6 and 9. So if any of those are... Yeah, actually, now that I said that, Mercury as well. Someone's going to talk to you. You're going to have some good... Or you're going to have really good communication with somebody. Really, really good. Could be anyone that you're thinking of. I do feel like it's somebody worthwhile, somebody who wants a long-term relationship with you, or somebody who could be like a good work partner, could be trying to find a lodger, and you need a lodger, something like that. It feels like something, it could literally be anything that you're waiting on communication for, and it feels really healthy, very healthy, beautiful, exactly, yep. Could even be someone who you had a past life with, and I'm also hearing a past love with. Could even just be, excuse me, could be somebody, oh my God. Oh my God, this is so sexy, this energy. This is like full on sex. This is giving me vibes. Right, Wednesday. Okay, I'm not really too keen on these cards. I'm not going to take them. Not feeling it. Okay, so this is giving me the vibes that for some of you, obviously if you are of age, it's one somebody you have slept with and they're coming back, but it could also be somebody who's just really, really interested in you. Wow. Oh my God, this is beautiful. So you could be a water sign, or they could be a water sign. You could also be an earth sign, or they could be an earth sign. This is Thursday. Let's have a look at Friday. Got two cards for Friday. Oh, guys, you have the most amazing freaking week. Oh my freaking God. Oh my God. Sorry, guys. I'm just like, okay, I don't have much to say. Beautiful. This was meant to come out. I didn't take this card, but it's come out again, so that's beautiful. I love it when they do that. Thank you very much for that clarity. They're like, Vicky, why are you putting that card back? Why are you doing this to it? Why are you doing that to us? Right, beautiful. Something is really shaking you up. Beautiful. Guys, you have a fucking stunning week. Oh my God. Okay, I need to calm down. I need to take a chill pill. Right. A lot of you guys ending in a relationship very similar to group one, actually. So go to group one if you resonate with this one, if you feel the need to. Oh, sorry guys, just moving my camera. Right, start of the week, beautiful. New offer coming in, lovely. Can be to do somebody you're really, really wanting to connect with. Can be a new partner. Can be somebody you literally don't know. You literally don't know who this is, and they're taking action on you, or you're taking action on them, and you're really happy about it. Rainbows can be a really good sign. I've been seeing a lot of rainbows. I've seen two. One that was very faded a couple of months ago, and one that was really, really intense. It was absolutely beautiful. When I saw that a couple of days ago, I'm like, whoa. Something to do with like a treasure chest. And funny enough, I found a Lego treasure chest a couple of days ago, very random. And yeah, so definitely some sort of offer coming in, who's someone who's just gonna make you really happy. By the way, guys, this doesn't have to mean a relationship. This can mean a friendship. This can mean, like, I'm hearing like a manager. So it could be a new manager coming in. It makes you feel really good about your work. But it can just be somebody who just freaking lights you up and makes you feel so freaking good. It doesn't have to be someone new. It can just be someone who you form a really good friendship with, and it could just be because it's like slowly forming. But I do feel like it can cause a little bit of insecurity on Saturday. This is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So there's definitely some sort of ending to an old time, whatever that mean in love, whether that mean in mindset, job, and even an old cycle, guys, that you're not even properly aware of. It can be subconscious as well. The universe is like, bitch, let's get her out of there. Let's get him out of there. So with the Hermit, this is basically you guys really thinking about what's going on, and you're like, boom, Sunday is going to be absolutely amazing. You guys are really reaping the rewards, and you're going to have an absolutely gorgeous time. This is about you just kind of contemplating, should I have done this? Should I have done this? This is very similar message to group number one. And you should, because it's amazing. And I feel like you've got some really good stuff coming in. For those of you who are wanting a relationship, boom, I can see that happening this week. I can see a new relationship for me. I can see someone coming out the absolute blue, so freaking randomly. I'm hearing the club. I'm hearing a shopping center. I'm hearing a bakery, cooking, an oven. I'm seeing an oven. I'm seeing washing up. Something to do with like cooking or culinary class, college. I'm hearing play school. I'm hearing plastic surgery. I'm hearing a lot of random words. Kitchen, knife and fork. You know, I'm seeing all the kind of like just random places I'm really picking up. Even cafe. I'm hearing cafe. Del Mar, which is an artist, pretty sure, like a singer. Cafe au lait, okay. And I'm hearing like cafetiere. So there's lots of like to do with like culinary, like food, and yeah, I'm hearing food and water, clubs, pubs, you know, that sort of thing, guys. I'm sorry I'm giving you so many details, but I really feel the need to kind of give you loads of different information. I'm just seeing fireworks, like pew, 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 pew. I'm literally hearing it going pew, 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 like little tiny fireworks, like pew. You see someone and like a little one goes off in your head and it's like pew. But you can't like let anyone know because you're in public, and it'll be embarrassing if you're like, oh my God, he's so hot. Oh my God, she's so attractive. But yeah, I don't know. Just some really good communication coming in, guys. I am full on loving this. I can see flowers blooming as well. Flowers, daisies. Oh my God, this is amazing. I'm seeing like hearts everywhere. Pew, 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 like that. Pew. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you like this reading, don't forget to give a big old thumbs up, subscribe. And if you'd like to get a private reading from me, all my information is down below. And I'll speak to you very soon. Namaste. Much love. Bye. Hello, group number three. Let's get started with your reading. Let's see what's going on for you in your week. So these readings have been very, very, very positive up until now. So let's go. You and your loved ones are safe. Beautiful. So for group number one and group number two, they both had Aries energy and now you've got Cancer, which is stunning. Love that. We then have Observer. Ooh, oh, look at the little fox. Oh my God. Sorry, guys. This is a new deck. I haven't actually really looked at these cards too intensely. Because I recently just got this deck from someone, bought it from my Amazon wish list. So thank you so much. If you would like to purchase a card deck for me, you can always do that and you get a reading. You don't have to, but you can have a reading. And all the information is down below. I have my Amazon wish list in the description as well. Co-create. Oh, I love this. So cute. I love these little animals. I love that little fox. He's beautiful. We've got the moon as well with Cancer, which is lovely. And then we also have, oh, wow. Oh my God. I was not expecting that. Oh, this is good. This is good. This is a good, wow. Sorry guys, I'm going to get so excited. Anything to do with relationships, I'm like, oh my God. Okay, I need to chill. Right. Okay. So for you guys, you could be quite overwhelmed and feeling a little bit unsafe, a little bit insecure. That's totally fine. Someone's going to help you out. I see a friend coming in. I see friendships just helping you out, or just someone helping you out of the blue. So for a lot of you, you guys could be observing your relationship and thinking, do I want to keep this? Do I want to stay in it? And some of you guys, you could be breaking up if that's what you want. But if not, I do see a lot of you coming together in a relationship with someone. Partnerships, companions, even a best friend, getting like thinking about marriage, that sort of thing. There's definitely some sort of unlikely pairing because we've got like an owl and a leopard. So for a lot of you guys, you're going to think, oh, I don't know if I can trust this person. Because then it's quite far away, it's quite like a distance. But you guys are really coming out of your shell and you're going to really kind of find this person very attractive, possibly taller than you. You know, especially if you're a female wanting a male, I see this person being taller than you. I just sense like a female to male relationship. Obviously, it doesn't have to be for everyone. I see someone observing you as well. And you're thinking, no, I'm not safe. I can't open up to this person, especially if you have Cancer in your chart. Extra points to you. But it just feels like, yeah, I can't open up to this person. I don't know what to do. But for a lot of you, you're going to have a lot of support. And you're going to have a lot of change in your relationships this week. You're going to have the way you see relationships. And the way you observe relationships is going to be very feminine and passionate. And it's going to be very kind of supportive. And we've got like a woman's face here with the moon, which is actually very Cancerian. Here, guys, I don't know if you can see it. Because basically, the Cancerian energy is very female, very feminine. It's ruled by the moon. So lovely, guys. You guys are balancing things out this week as well. Wherever, if you don't want love, you're just balancing things out. Lovely, absolutely gorgeous. And I say, these readings don't have to resonate to everyone. Oh my God, I just realised something. You both have an egg. You have an egg twice. He's sitting on an egg, and there's an egg there. Wow, you guys are really coming out of your shell and observing things in a different light. Wow, that is stunning. And also, we've got like an egg with a fox, and then we've got an egg with like a leopard. And also, I just realised there's like a... Oh my God, I don't know if this is... I don't think this is in every card, but there's like a face... here, like a woman's face, and then we've also got a woman's face here. So what is going on is you're being very nurturing to your inner child. This is so cute. I love this deck. Oh my God, I thought I wouldn't really like this deck very much because it can be quite random, but I've literally fallen in love with this. I only thought for like a second that I wouldn't like it. You know, like a second, but oh my God, I freaking love it. Right, Monday, beautiful. Yes, exactly, as I say, opening up, letting go of things on Monday. Tuesday, what we have on the Tuesday. Something to do with your house on Monday as well. Something to do with your house. You might already be in Monday, just to let you guys know. I'm filming this on Sunday night, okay? Five of Cups, Two of Pentacles. Possibly wanting to move house, wanting to get away. This can also be to do with work life, guys. Just take it as it resonates. Leaving something you think is unbalanced. And finding something else that's concrete. Working on your coin this week. Very strong coin, very strong working on the coin this week. And we also got the Nine of Swords on Thursday. So you guys are really going through quite a lot of emotion. I'm not surprised with this full moon in Pisces. We then have the Eight of Wands on Friday. Saturday, Three of Wands. Sorry guys, it's quite late now. And then we have the Six of Pentacles on Sunday. Definitely an element of balance, because almost got you balancing this, and we've got the scales here on this card, and then we also have, where did I see it? Oh, scales here. Definitely a balancing energy, a very Libra energy coming in. You guys are really kind of hearing bolting up and like preparing for something, and you possibly don't, oh, for some of you guys, you don't know if you should leave something behind, but you should. They're saying you, if you feel stable, if you feel unstable or unsafe, it's time to go, you know, and time to leave this old thing behind, or talk about it, you know. But I do feel like for a lot of you, you're really coming into union with people. Oh my God, and it says balance here as well. So definitely coming into union with people, definitely coming more, right, for a lot of you guys, if you've had struggles, relationships, and you are single, I do feel like for specifically those of you who are single and have had time away from like an ex or a partner, you guys are definitely thinking about your relationships and starting to get more balance in your love life and your friends as well. So also for some of you guys, keep coughing, they're about communication. You guys are really moving forward to something new that feels much more balanced for you guys. I feel like this is a roller coaster this week. This is an absolute roller coaster. Can we have the general energy for this week, please? Beautiful, powerful, powerful energy. Old cycle, leaving old cycles, very, very powerful energy. Extremely powerful. I love that, guys. So that's amazing. I'm gonna pull you one more card because I love group number three. That was my fave. That was my fave. They always get more cards. Not that I deliberately do that. Well, I am now, but spirit guides always give me extra cards. Dreams. Exactly. This is extremely Pisces. Neptune rules Pisces. So that's amazing. So literally, you're really tuning into this Pisces energy. Imagination, subconscious, self-sacrifice, meditation. Empathy, fantasy. So a lot of you guys, you possibly could be fantasizing about like a new relationship, or like you could have been having dreams about somebody coming in, that sort of thing. Whatever resonates with you guys. And if you see any symbolism here that's for you, then you know, take it as it resonates. And then have revolution. Yeah, breakthroughs, brainstorming, the unexpected, literally, guys. Like there's so much unexpected energy this week for each group, you know. So for a lot of you guys, you're going to have quite an intense week, but I feel like it's going to be absolutely amazing for you and such a massive, huge breakthrough. Yeah, absolutely gorgeous technology as well. So it could be to do with Mercury retrograde effects in the technology too. So thank you so much for watching, guys. If you like this video, then please let me know down below in the comment section below, or you can give me a good old thumbs up. And yeah, I'll speak to you very soon. If you would like a private reading, all my information is down below, and I'll speak to you very soon. Much love. Bye. Oh, namaste. Bye.